Once upon a time, many years ago, lived California's most infamous hotel.
Look, there's another one. Look at him. I don't understand why God doesn't cleanse this planet. Send these lizards to fucking hell for eternity. Look at them. There's another one on the sidewalk over there. Look at the seagulls. Why are the seagulls away from the ocean? Why? They're supposed to be at the ocean. Look, there goes the McDonald's lady. This is the Garden of Allah. And McDonald's is staying open next year.
Hey, what's that sign say, man?
Oh, how long is it to you, but you put it in San Diego, San Diego, straight shit.
You're not into it?
Hey, I was thinking, man. Put that. I think you're quarter of that.
Thanks, brother.
Put it up.
I walked through the parking lot 10,000 times without caring. Until they dug it up. Whatever was underground here inspired the most creative minds of our century to come. And when I say they're building the Tower of Babel here, I'm not joking. The lost Hinduist paradise, the Garden of Allah, was right here underneath Chase Bank in West Hollywood. All of the city's biggest stories and scandals happened in this foundation behind these walls.
In a fair Egyptian garden, where pretty lotus lilies grow, that's where my thoughts tonight are going.
This property.
What are they going to find?
A lot of skeletons. This is Indian burial ground. That's what this is. They built all of these houses on Indian burial ground. There's Indian arrowheads and there's seashells all here. Look, get this on your video, bro.
He says that he's willing to do the documentary for $1 million.
I'm going to. What do you think?
It happened
about
right
that?
Here. You have no idea where you're sitting on, my brother.
It's
no
idea. Here.
Right
lizard.
There, the hottest orgies in the
you
world.
Want me to,
literally.
Yeah. I command you, demon, go from here now. Quoted from the Bible. My friend, move your car over. I'm not making no money. You're scaring my clientele. I need money. Look at that. Look, get that on the video. Hurry up.
Forget about the Chateau Marmont and the Playboy Mansion. 100 years ago, the real den of debauchery was right here at the base of Laurel Canyon, the gateway to Sunset Boulevard. If you want to make it in Hollywood, you have to pass through these doors. The the hotel and parties were hosted by silent film star Alla Nazimova. By the age of 17, she was a star in Moscow, and shortly after found her fame on Broadway before moving to Los Angeles and creating The Garden.
It was all done right over here, and her movies were projected on the wall. Actually, we're a story above where all this happened, because this is not the ground floor here. You know, this is the second floor. It's below us that the Garden of Allah existed, with its pool. I had a lover who was on the cover of Life magazine, diving into the pool, the Garden of Allah. True story.
Ronald Reagan was rumored to turn one of the bungalows into a harem.
All right, now take a deep breath and hope. I'll try not to hurt.
And Nazimova introduced Ronald to her good friend, Nancy. Marilyn Monroe and her starlets would sit by the poolside, sipping on glasses of gin martinis. And it wasn't just actors and politicians. Mobsters also occupied the Garden of Allah.
Going by the name of what?
They go by Jesus. When they think I'm poor, I don't have to do it. I put that Jesus. They don't give a damn about me. Nancy. And sometimes.
Why do they call you Jesus?
I look like the Messiah. This one, and they look. And that's the fact. Meditation sessions and probably this.
When they go krr, krr, they have a ball inside.
Look at their, all four of them are up here, dude. Look at them all.
They're laughing at you. They're like, heck, there he is, the fucking director, producer of the Garden of Allah. They're laughing at you. They know that you're making the fucking movie.
I want to go in there.
He unlocked the lock. Jerry doesn't go in there.
He won't even talk to me about it.
He won't. He doesn't have the key.
But he knows it's there.
Yeah. I went in with a 38 hollow point, fully loaded. We got to the entrance of the catacomb and we went back out, because it's just too fucking creepy. There are 5,000 spirits in that fucking catacomb.
There was definitely some unexplainable dark energy in these tunnels. In this foundation is where Mickey Cohen and Bugsy Siegel ran their rackets and wrote a piece of Hollywood history known as the Jewish Mafia. Together, they ruled Los Angeles and the movie industry.
That's how the bad people in the mafia and everything escaped the police. From the Garden of Allah.
And Villa number 24, it was one of Ernest Hemingway's and Albert Einstein's favorite bungalow. Both Albert Einstein and Alla Nazimova shared the same love for classical music. And right by the poolside, under the shadows of the palms, they would collaborate and play music together.
Just at the beginning of the Sunset Strip, Sunset Boulevard, and it's Los Angeles. It's a city, whereas West Hollywood is below. There was a whole van and like a trailer, and they hauled the girls in, but they nabbed the Johns. They arrested the men. Very young, very, very too young women, and probably boys.
The garden was a lavish playground. Exotic plants surrounded the 25 Spanish-style villas and extravagant water fountains. Everyone who was anyone in Hollywood wanted to be here. Natsumova installed the pool shaped like the Black Sea. And despite her fame and fortune and the power she bestowed, ironically, in the end she became embarrassed and burned most of her films. In 1942, tragedy struck. Hotel clerk was shot 5 times, 3 in the back and 2 in the chest, before the bandits vanished into the catacombs. It was in this bungalow, next to the water fountain, where Scott Fitzgerald sent the famous postcard to himself. Dear Scott, how are you? I've been wanting to come see you. I've been living in the Garden of Allah.
The locusts showed up where they've never been before. They showed up in the desert. Locusts don't go to the desert. But they had the swarm of locusts in Las Vegas. That's biblical, Kevin. That's in the Bible. I can't remember what part of the Bible, but that's in the Bible. This demolition is going so slow on this building. The supervisor told me, he made the mistake of telling me. He said, we're not in a hurry to demo it because they found something. They found the catacomb.
The more time I spent here discovering what's underneath this parking lot, I realized the ravens were messengers that are able to travel between our world and the spiritual one.